So, you might have heard of the Honor Play, the first device to ship with the company's brand new GPU turbo technology. And Honor is very proud of this tech, but what is it, and does it actually work? Long story short, it's quite a big deal, but in this video we're going to take a bit of a deeper dive. GPUs, or graphics processing units in smartphones, have always faced a series of technical constraints, such as size, heat, and energy consumption. Well, GPU Turbo is a piece of software that works as a bridge between a game and the GPU on your phone, and there are two clever things going on here. Number one, it takes a peek at the next few frames in advance before they actually need to be rendered. The bottom left is what you might see on screen, but the top right is showing that the GPU is a couple of steps ahead. It's anticipating what's coming next. And by being able to do this, you're much less likely to have sudden dips in frame rate. Number two, it allows the phone to see what aspects of a frame are constant and which need to be re-rendered, as opposed to just re-rendering the whole frame 60 times per second. So in this instance, you can see we've got a main character that is moving through a scene where a lot of the elements are completely static. With GPU Turbo, your phone only needs to bear the burden of processing the movement of your character, and not everything. By doing this, it streamlines the phone's graphic workload and effectively reduces the burden on its GPU. There is another benefit here, Smart Shock. With games that have been optimized, you actually get vibration feedback. In PUBG, for example, you'll feel it when you fire a gun, change a weapon, or get hit, and after a bit, you stop actively noticing it, but it does add a meatiness to the combat, which you'll miss when you play it on other phones. There is also simulated surround audio on games that have been optimized, but it is still only coming out the bottom speaker. So, how well does it work? Well, to give you an idea, gameplay of PUBG Mobile feels just as smooth as on my Galaxy Note 9, a phone that isn't just 3 times more expensive, but on paper, more powerful. The average frame rate on the Note is 2-3 FPS higher, but GPU Turbo keeps the minimum frame rate just as high, if not higher, on the Honor. Because frames are being pre-calculated, it reduces those moments of random slowdown, and acts more as an FPS stabilizer than an FPS booster. By reducing the amount of work that the GPU needs to do, the battery life is also boosted. You can expect an extra 10-15% endurance when gaming. That is the equivalent of a hardware refresh, so not too shabby. The Honor Play already has a beefy 3750mAh battery, so this equates to about 5 hours of straight PUBG Mobile gaming. What will be interesting to see is when they implement this tech into their MUI software skin to take advantage of the performance and efficiency gains no matter what you're doing. Alright, what about the rest of the phone? Well, there are 3 colours, ultraviolet being the most unusual, and I gotta say, whilst it's not the one I would use on a day-to-day basis, it's different in a good way. I can see the appeal. It's a slim, flat phone with a robust metal body, and the matte finish means it'll stay pretty much clear of fingerprints, which is kind of a pet peeve of mine. There is a little bit of rattle that seems to come from the camera module. Nothing alarming but worth pointing out, and the antenna bands are pretty noticeable, especially on the violet version. To round off the hardware, you've got a headphone jack, USB Type-C port, and a single mono speaker. The phone is based on the Kirin 970 chip and 4 GB of RAM, which for the price is good hardware. This is the same chip seen on last year's €800 Mate 10. I was kind of surprised when I ran AnTuTu on this versus my Galaxy Note 9, it was within 10%. That's pretty good considering how far apart those phones are price-wise. Love it or hate it, the camera is packed with Honor's AI features. You've got those super punchy, super bright, vivid colors that you come to expect from an Honor AI phone, and you're backing that up with 16 megapixels of detail. You've got a 2 megapixel secondary sensor, used solely for depth perception, and for this it's tough to complain, it doesn't do a bad job at all. Now, the first thing you're going to notice when you turn the phone on is the display, and it's an area of relative strength. We're talking a 6.3-inch IPS LCD, and I gotta say I was a little nervous to try it because LCDs traditionally don't have the best colour and contrast available, but the Honor Play surprised me. It's a head and shoulders above a lot of budget LCD panels. The bezel is pretty slim too, actually a fraction slimmer than the iPhone X from 3 angles, but just with a bit of a chin at the bottom. I did like the fingerprint scanner, it's easy to reach, and it's on its own here, so there's no chance of accidentally placing your fingers on the camera. Alright guys, so that is GPU Turbo, as well as a quick overview of the Honor Play that comes bundled with it. Let me know what you guys think of the technology and the phone in the comments below. This phone has just become available on the Honor official website, Amazon UK, Argos, Carphone Warehouse, the list goes on. So thanks a lot for watching, I'll drop some links in the description below, and I'll catch you guys next time.